Okay, listen up now.
So my presentation on the Tony Award-winning musicals of the year before they got the award.
It's real sensitive, so back it up. There you go.
Okay, so I have the years that they were running before they got the award, and the numbers are referring to how many Tony Award ceremonies they were running before they got the award, because the Tony Awards happened in the summer, so if they came out later that year, it wouldn't really make sense just to do the year. So as you can see, this is over 50 years of data. So as you can see for this part, mostly the year that came out and just the year after. Some like cast took a few years. And Memphis took 8. And not sure if you saw that, but Les Miserables also took 7 years. So they're the outliers here. Most of them took either the year they came out or just a couple years afterward to actually get the award for Best Musical of the Year. And they're just Memphis and Les Miserables that took 7 or 8. So you can see my seven with the plot there. Minimum was 0. Most of them took only 1 year. Memphis took 8. Their deviation is just over a year and a half. From a 69 in Paris. So I believe that the reason that some of them took longer, like Fully Modern Millie and most of those other ones, were more for entertainment. They're musical just to make you laugh, they're comedic, and just have a good time. So those took, they soared the first couple of years they were around and then kind of died off. Most of them actually, except for one play, all the plays only got the award once, so they got really popular when they first came out. Memphis and Les Miserables were not as popular. They took a while to get their fame. I think it's because they're more historical. They're not for comedy, they're not just having a good time, also it's because they can learn something. So that's why I think those should fall.